Things were going from bad to worse. We had to sort something out about her dog. Dad said that she had to be put down, but Ness had promised Ellen we'd do something. I hadn't got a clue what. On top of that, Dad had invited Mr. Gerald, his old boss, to stay. He was an oily old creep. Couldn't keep his eyes off Ness. She didn't exactly like it.
Bye! I thought I'd see you at break.
Yeah, well, I was busy.
Writing poetry.
What did you want, then?
Just hang on a minute. I wanted to say something. Warn you, that's all.
Oh, yeah? What about?
You know what they said on the news last night? About hoarders and so on.
No, not really. I stopped listening.
Hoarders have a week to give up their food supplies. Well, in a way, I suppose Dad's a hoarder, isn't he?
What do you mean, suppose? He's a hoarder, right? Nothing else for it.
Well, I know you don't like it. I know Ness hates it. Well, we get food in our bellies, don't we? And that's more than you can say for after kids around here. So keep your mouth shut or Dad gets it.
What?
The Nick. They'll put him away, you know. I don't know why, but they will.
Maybe because he's keeping food back from people who are starving hungry. Seems a pretty good reason to me.
He's doing it for us. So keep your mouth shut, OK?
No sign of intelligent life. Beam me up. OK?
What's that?
Prison.
That's what he said.
Serve him right.
Oh, come on, Ness. Your own dad.
He doesn't care about everything. Oh, forget it. She's hungry, Barry.
You said you'd do something about her as well. You know what he'll do. If she's still here when Dad gets...
Nessie, I thought you were going out. And, oh, come on, get Inca off the table.
Inca, get off.
And Barry, Dad told you to go and get some meat. Now, the money's over there in an envelope. A couple of chops, if you can.
If you'll sell me anything.
Mum, I think Terry's mum would have Inca. If you could help feed her.
She knows I'm going.
Oh, don't be silly, Ellen. She can't feed you and the dog.
Just a few bones. Please, Mr. Adams, we just want a few bones. I could make soup.
Sorry, nothing. The cupboard is bare. You can see them.
Look, I've got a few pounds saved. I thought maybe...
No, love. Not for money, love. I'm sorry.
Oh. Sorry. Hello. No point in asking, is there?
Not much, son. I say, you're Norman Mortimer's lad, aren't you?
What of it?
Come here a minute, lad. Shut the door. You could have that.
I haven't got enough of that.
No, not for money, lad. I need shoes. Your dad sells shoes. He needs meat. I sell that. Now, nothing said, of course. Not a word. You do understand me, don't you? Or we could all be in a lot of bother. You're a bright lad, son. Give my compliments.
Well, hang on a minute. I don't get it. You told that girl that
she's got nothing for me, has she? Supply and demand, my lad. You'll learn. No. Here you are.
Thanks.
I don't want to go, Mum.
Oh, do you good, love. Get out and play with your friends for a bit.
I've got nothing to take, no present.
Well, nobody expects presents these days, Ellen. Everything's too expensive.
I don't want to.
When I was a little boy, Ellen, I did as I was told, or I knew the reason why. That's what my father used to say. Do as you're told, or know the reason why.
I don't care what your father said.
I don't think your father would want to know that you've been rude to his guest.
Don't threaten Ellen. I won't stand for it.
May, my tea. Where is it?
Come on, love. Let's get your cardigan. There you are. Go on, off you go.
skin was so cold. It's so cold that my...
Hello. Hello, the son.
It's me, Dad.
You're going to the party too, darling? Come on, get in. Come on, son. Yeah, good lad. What's your name in Gorgeous?
Ellen. Ellen Mortimer. For the party, I thought.
A good idea. Take you one. I think I should have a ticket.
Right, get on with it, Cliff.
Norman.
Change all the price tags for the new ones. 38% rise
Norman.
In... Norman. 38% rise in all prices. You'll need the calculator.
Hello, Mrs...
What you doing here, May?
Norman, I want to talk to you.
I haven't got time now, May. I don't approve of family things and work being mixed, I've told you.
I want to know about Mr. Gerald.
What about him?
I want to know what you've told
him. Mr. Gerald's been very good to me. Promised me a directorship. I owe him a great deal.
You don't owe him anything. You never were made a director, never.
It's hardly his fault if he was bought out. He tried, he told me.
And you believed him?
Look, keep your voice down. I'm not going to discuss the man behind his back. It's a principle of mine. He's a friend.
I wouldn't be too sure about that. Norman, I don't like him. Nessie doesn't either. The way he looks at her.
She could do a sight worse for herself than Mr. Gerald. I'd be proud, I can tell you.
I don't believe you.
Look, she'd do better with him than some of the layabouts she seems to hang about with.
I just want to know how long he's staying. You said a few days. It's been a week already.
He stays as long as he likes. The poor man's just lost his housekeeper. He can hardly be expected to look after himself, a man like that. He came to me as a friend, and I'm not turning him away.
He's eating us out of house and home. And he told Ellen off this afternoon. I'm not standing for that.
You'll put up with it, May. I say so, and that's flat. And what Agnes likes or doesn't like cuts no ice with me. And if Ellen starts being rude to him, she can watch out, too. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, bye, Mrs. Moore.
Here we are. Show them what you brought, love.
I want to. Come on, put it on the table, Ellen.
Seen Ham like that for, oh, I don't know how long.
Ask her where she got them from.
Where'd you get them, Ellen? Did you nick them?
You didn't do anything wrong, did you? I mean, they haven't been in the shops these days. Oh, not like that. Did you take them? I mean, look what they cost.
I thought you'd like them.
They do, darling, but where did you get them?
Your mum said they're the last we... Well, there isn't really enough to go round our family, so she thought you might like them.
Are you sure, love?
Yes, I'm sure.
Stop, keep that. Before you'll get this chair.
No. Come here, son. Now, look. I've got to go and see a man about a dog. That girl, what's her name?
Ellen. Ellen Mortimer. I told you about her.
Yeah, you did. Keep your eyes open. Be your old man, mate. And I'll look after you as always. I'll see you later, son.
Okay. Ta-ra.
God bless you. No closer is he at the moment. There's a warehouse I know that he's absolutely snapped. And the watchman here owes me a favour or two, so we've got no sweat there. The main problem you've got is excess in and out of the area of the sewer stuff. And as we both know, the police these days are getting a little bit heavy on anybody starting up a bit of business on the side. So we're going to need some sweetness for them. Cans of food. Bottles of drink, that sort of thing.
Food? Where the hell are we getting food from? There's nothing about at the moment.
I'm not so sure about that, my old son. Not that I can help you. At a price, of course. Your people can pay. I can come up with the goods. Oh, and I don't want no more English money. I want Swiss francs, gold, jewelry, that sort of thing. No more English money. Are you telling that, son?
Well, I'm not so sure about that.
Then no more supplies from your old muffins. You tell Mum that's something big. Goodbye.
Okay, I'll see what I can do.
You do that, Sunshine.
Agree, Norman. It's disgraceful.
Smashing places for the sake of it, destroying property. It's sheer jealousy.
I just want to get food and clothes to people who don't have them. And can't afford to buy them.
Oh, my dear Nessie, you heard the man. There was nothing in the shop. That was why he closed.
Oh, that's all lies. That isn't true.
How on earth can you say that? You weren't there.
Forget it.
She cares about the old folk, Norman. We all do, my dear, but taking the law into one's own hands is never right.
If people get fed...
Your kindness does you great credit. I wonder... Nessie, I know you must be very busy, but it would give me great pleasure if you'd do me the honour of accepting something from me.
What?
This, my dear. I bought it specially. I have the other ticket. I thought we'd go to the theatre and then maybe dinner. I'm sure we could find somewhere. One of my old haunts could find us a tolerable meal. A birthday treat, my dear.
Can't say fairer than that, Agnes. She'd be delighted to go, Gerald.
I will not. I don't want to go, no.
Agnes? Agnes?
Oh, not yet, Norm. I'll have a little chat with her later. She'll come with me.
Who went out just now?
Nessie. She seemed a bit... She was crying, I think.
I'm not at all surprised. I've got something for you to take, you'll know where. And give Inca a big hug from me, right?
Thanks, Mum.
I saw it!
Yeah, okay, Miss. Look, just tell us again, and this time leave out the shouting.
I saw Terry and these others. They broke into the shop, took out boxes and boxes of food and things. But on the news, the owner says there was nothing there. No food, no nothing. He was lying.
What's so funny? I said, what's so funny, huh?
He's been robbed of stuff he shouldn't be hoarding. No, even if Terry does like he says, you know, he's going to give it all away. What's the bloke going to say? Oh, please, mister, I want all my stores back. If he says that, the police are going to bust him for breaking the law. So all he can say is nothing.
It's still thieving, though, isn't it?
I don't know. Not these days, anyway. I mean, the other's just plain greed, isn't it? No, I don't think it is thieving.
Dad does. Him and that creep Gerald. He asked me to go to the theatre with him. Dinner afterwards, he said. Have you seen the way he eyes me up and down? It makes me sick.
What do you mean?
Oh, that's right. Dad almost seems to encourage it. Oh, I don't know what's wrong with him.
Yes, you do.
What is?
Oh, nothing.
What's wrong?
Nothing, nothing.
Suit yourself.
Come on, Ace. Home time.
I can go over there anytime. It's lovely there, Barry.
I'm not staying there, Terry. I can't.
So where are you going to go?
I don't know. Just can't stand the atmosphere. Dirty old man.
Yeah, well, I'll have a word with him.
I just want to leave that house.
You can't leave. Daddy goes spare. Mum, too. Hope you realise if you leave now, it's me, Mum and Ellen against the rest. Well, Jeff thinks that everything Dad does is great. Mr. Gerald is always poking his nose in, snooping around. I just can't walk out.
Could if I had somewhere close to stay, couldn't I?
I gotta ask my mum. She'd like it.
I'm 18 next month. I can stick it till then.
You would dare to go airless? You and me?
I don't care. I want to.
Oi! Come on, you two, we'll be late. Can you take Inca, Terry?
Come on.
Hey.
Come here.
Be careful.
Come on, we're going this way. Oi. Oi.
You see her later. Come on, behave yourself.
Did you mean it then? About leaving?
Yeah.
Will his mum have you?
I think so.
All right. Well, we'll all miss you.
I'll miss you too.
Okay. Okay. Oh, Mel, Wendy. Mm. What do you want?
About Ellen. We thought there was some more of what you brought to the party.
You what? Look, we don't like to beg from you. It's just that we saw those tins of ham and we had a taste. And
oh, come on, love.
Come in. What tins, Mel?
She brought some tins of ham. Two tins. They must have cost 300 quid.
Nessie? Get Ellen. She's in her room.
Look, we didn't want to. It's just that there's so many of our friends and relations that haven't got anything at all.
Their problem, not ours. Shut it, Jeff, or you get filled in, right?
Not by you.
Come on, it's all right.
Okay, what's this about ham?
Nothing. Look, we just thought there might be some other stuff. A tin somewhere.
Tell them, Ellen.
There's nothing else.
Nothing else. It's just my mum said...
So you got that, did you? The cans were leftovers. And mum thought they'd make a good present for you kids. You know what it's like. No one's got anything these days.
No. No, you don't mind us just asking, do you?
Of course not. Sorry.
Look, I'll see you, Wendy, all right?
You think you can make a big deal out of having cans of food? Do you know what I mean?
Shut up, Jeff. She's afraid.
Afraid? She'll be more afraid when they cart Dad off for hoarding, won't she? Taking all our stores. Giving us nothing back. How do we live? How did you get the stuff?
No one knows. Sin and I took it.
You were told not to go down there. Never. Dad told you. I'm telling him.
She was right.
You think what you like, Ness. But you eat the food, don't you? If it chokes you, stop eating like all the rest. Starve to death. You would if it wasn't for what Dad's done. He could have gone to prison just because she wanted to be big. I'm telling him.
Don't.
You're not getting away with it. No chance.
You're not telling him, Jeff.
Says who?
Says me. You tell Dad and I'll tell Terry. First of all, he can sort you out, and then while he's here, him and his mates can go down to the cellar and take the rest of that damn food and give it to people who really need it. You tell him about Ellen and that's what happens.
You wouldn't. That's betrayal.
What of? You? Dad? There are hungry people out there, Jeff. Wendy Farrar, those kids and the rest. And you just want to hang on to whatever you happen to have. And don't you care?
I don't give a damn about Mel. And I'm not soft on Wendy Farrar.
Stop it! Stop it!
Look, it's like Dad says. Help comes to those who help themselves.
That's right, Jeff. Well, you tell Dad and Terry can help himself. All right? Right? Remember what Cliff said about being scared? He's right.
I don't know. It's just like a war in here. You, me and Ellen against the rest. Just like a war.
Assured the Senate committee that there was no reason to fear that OPEC would raise the price of oil to their domestic market in the way that they had in Britain. The dollar, he said, is still firm. In Leeds, the chief of police has appealed at a meeting with local journalists for responsible reporting of the present crisis.